Video, we're continuing on with our CSS chapter, and we're gonna dive into a topic called overflow. So we'll look at that. Hope you're enjoying it so far. If you are, please comment, like, subscribe, and let me know if you have any questions. I'll do my best, depending on what platform you're on, to answer your questions. More importantly, it'd be nice if we could build a community where you guys help each other. Because I'm only one person, I may not be able to get to everyone's questions. I know right now on my channels on Rumble, and if you're watching this on BitChute, I don't have very many subscribers, so it may not seem like a lot, but like on YouTube, I have like 10,000 subscribers currently, and it gets to be just a little bit overwhelming to try to keep up with everything. So it's probably not reasonable or possible for me to keep up with all discussions on all platforms. So I may be announcing something pretty cool later on, to where we can see all this in a centralized location and I can keep up with conversations there. But for now, I want to encourage people to use alternative platforms like Rumble and BitChute and Odyssey and things like that. I'm not currently going to be posting on Odyssey just yet. I may do that very soon, but I'm going to focus on Rumble. Rumble's been awesome so far. I've seen a lot of new features added just since I created my account, and their support is really awesome too. I had an issue where some of my videos were showing up even though they were scheduled, and they fixed it very, very quickly. And I also had a feature request talking about needing playlists to help organize this series, and they said that is on the way. So hopefully we'll have a playlist soon, or by the time maybe you're watching this video, there already is a playlist. But thanks to the guys at Rumble, and thank you to everyone at BitChute. And so let's support alternative tech, people who believe in free speech, and people who aren't going to censor you based on your beliefs or values. Okay, with that being said, let's jump right in. Let me switch over to my screen here. All right. I need to get one of those cool little deck leg things that I can click on and change my scenes easily so I don't have to look over at OBS. This is how I'm doing it for now. So let's talk about overflow. In order to demonstrate overflow, we have this long bit of text on our index.html that I think I'm going to use here to demonstrate this. And to do that, we have, let's see, did we set this up as a paragraph? Let's look at that. I mean, again, it doesn't really matter if it's a paragraph or a div, but it is set up as a paragraph, which is fine. I'm going to add a little bit more styling here. And I think what I want to do is give this just a very slight gray background. So first of all, let's just do a background color, and let's try our hexadecimal handout here, and let's see if FFF is going to be white, then we can lower those values down closer to the black and start making it gray. So let's try, instead of FFF, let's try and maybe a BBB and see what that looks like. I didn't save. Let me save and then refresh. Okay, that's a little dark, but we can work with that. So you can look, since we are adding a different background, perhaps we should give it a little bit of padding as well. So let's give this some padding. And I'm going to give it a padding of, let's say, 12 pixels on the top and 8 pixels on the sides there. All right, and that makes that look just a little bit nicer there. The next thing I want to do is the elements inside of HTML grow to fit their content. But sometimes we want to limit the size, maybe the height or the width of this. And we can do this in two ways. We can set an explicit height, and we can say this height of this should only be 200 pixels or 100 pixels. We can also allow it to shrink down if it gets smaller, and then have a max height. So that's what we're going to do here. Let's put a maximum height. I haven't shown you this yet. This is pretty cool. Let's do a max height of 200, say 250 pixels. So let's refresh and see what happens here. Okay, so this element now is a maximum height of 250 pixels. But you'll notice, and you can see the footer right below that where it should be, but you'll notice that the content doesn't fit in there. And the content just breaks out and keeps going and breaks the layout of the entire page. And I don't want this to happen on this current situation. There may be instances where you do want this to happen, but the way that we control this is with a property called overflow. Now, overflow is just like this, and the default value of this is visible. And that is what we're seeing right now. So if I refresh, this isn't going to change. Okay, there is another one we can use called hidden, and sometimes this is great. You'll end up using this a lot. And if I refresh, now you can see it doesn't break my layout, and I have my footer here. Let me just close down my inspector for the time being. So you can see that this doesn't break my layout, and my footer's here. However, you can see some content in there. It's just kind of cut off, and I can't see that content at all. And there's no way for me to scroll or anything like that to see it. So the other thing I can do is I can actually add this value as scroll. Now if I refresh, it puts a little scroll bar there, and I have the ability to then scroll inside of there. Now this content, this element, this paragraph element we set up stays the same exact height, but you can see that now I can scroll and read everything, and it doesn't break the layout on my page. Okay. The other thing that we want to do here is you can see that the scroll property will add scroll bars even if it doesn't need them. And so, what a better option in most cases is to use auto. Now, auto will add a scroll bar if it needs it, but it won't have one if it doesn't need it. So now you can see we don't have a horizontal scroll bar here on the bottom because it doesn't scroll left or right, but it does have a scroll bar up top here. Okay, so you can see that. Now, if I were to comment out this maximum height, this is going to go back to full height, and you can see there's no scroll bar inside of here because now this grows to fit its content. There's no reason for overflow. So overflow, it only comes into effect if the content inside of an element is going to come out of the element in some way. And so that happens when you set a set height or width on things. And so now it uses that overflow property. And my favorite is probably the overflow auto. Now there will be situations where you may in fact want to use overflow hidden. Usually it's not a good idea for text unless you're doing something like a preview of some text, things like that, or but it works really well for images and things like that where you may want to just crop off an image that's in a parent div like this or a parent element. But this is the overflow property, and you will find yourself using this quite often. It's really neat. So anyhow, I hope that makes sense. Practice with it. Go ahead and you can look it up on W3 Schools and Mozilla's documentation for CSS. But create yourself a long div here and give it an overflow and a maximum height property. One thing we could also do, we could set a max width on this to, let's say, as 250 pixels as well. That's going to look a little funky. The text automatically wraps, so there's not going to be a horizontal scroll bar, but you can see this scroll is quite a bit more now because it's longer. The other thing I can do that's pretty cool is we could actually center this whole block if we wanted on the screen by giving this a value of, we can do margin, and I haven't shown you this yet, but we can do, I'm going to leave 0 pixels for the top and bottom. I typed O again, so 0 pixels for the top and bottom. And then if I do margin auto for the left and right, it's going to give the same amount of margin on each side, which will effectively center this div on the screen. So there may be a reason to do this. So that's pretty cool. But I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. I just wanted to show you that real quick. Oops. I just wanted to show you that real quick. I'm going to get rid of this margin auto there. And let's get rid of the maximum width. And hit save and refresh. And I think I'm just going to leave it like this. That way our page, it all still fits without scrolling the page. But if I want to read something inside this box, I can scroll that. All right, I will see you guys in the next video.